Hello, and welcome to Video 3 of the R2C Draft First Steps Tutorial Series. In the previous video, we installed the Dracula demo project that serves as a basis for this tutorial series. Today we will take a first look at the user interface, focusing on Jumpstart page, Main menu, and Navigator, and see how the workspace layout can be adapted to personal preferences. When starting R2C Draft for the first time, you might have noticed some windows opening up automatically. One is the in-app tutorial. The in-app tutorial is not tied in directly with this video series, but it might provide you with additional details if you are looking for specific information. You can always access it by clicking the tutorial bar in the top right corner of the screen. The other kind of self-opening windows are notifications. They inform you about important news around the software, like new patches, maintenance periods, etc. You can open notifications by clicking the envelope icon in the master toolbar. From the welcome screen, open the Dracula project now by double-clicking the preview image in the project list. The first thing you will see is the so-called Jumpstart page. By double-clicking the icons, you can easily move between different areas of the software. We will cover the most used ones during this series. You can always come back to the Jumpstart page by clicking the Home button in the top left corner. Let's take a closer look on how the workspace layout of R2C is organized. Double-click the Flow icon on the Jumpstart page so that we can see the standard workspace layout of the software. In the top left corner of the screen, we find the Main menu and Master toolbar. You might have noticed that these are always accessible, including the Jumpstart page and even the project selection. The Main menu gives you access to essential features, among them exports, means to contact the support, and the Close Project button. The drop-down menu at the bottom allows you to change the UI language of the application. The Master toolbar provides frequently used commands like Save Project and Undo Redo. The main window below is divided into two areas, the Navigator on the left and the Content area on the right. In the Navigator, you can find all data stored in a hierarchical object structure. You can expand or collapse entries just like in a Windows Explorer. The Content area and its toolbar are context-sensitive and may display different things depending on what kind of content you are viewing. We will take a detailed look at this when we get to the specific topics. If you need extra space or want to structure the content you see, you can create extra windows by clicking the New Window icon on the Master toolbar. Or you can create new tabs by clicking the plus icon, located in the top left corner of a window. Another way of organizing your workspace is to add additional view panes. You can do this by positioning the mouse cursor at the edge of the screen on any side. When the little icon with the two arrows appears, click, hold, and drag. With the same technique, you can resize panes as well. This marks the end of this video. We now know how the main R2C workspace looks like and how to travel between different program areas with the help of the Jumpstart page. In the next video, we will really get going with the creation of the main character for our story. Thank you for joining us, and join us again in our next tutorial.